another character which I don't use often. Just like gave him all the items. He's the poor guy who has to like, you know, now carry all the items. So he's the storage room. Okay, so we go. So here, oh, in Blackwood we just have, that's good. So. Yeah, the Finnish sauna, yeah, I know the name, but nobody knows where they originated. We come in half and all of Northern Europe further back than historical record. Well, North Sweden is really cold in winter. What is your favorite at the moment, CP? The old version I've read is the Irish story. What? But are not the from the native people in America? Is it not also something also what they did? You know, like this. I don't know how it's called in English, but you know, like sweat, it's called a sweating house to cleanse yourself and stuff like that. I think probably many people made this, also some kind of sauna, you know, with said, yeah, also I guess that many different, you know, people in the past did something similar, like a sauna. Maybe not like nowadays, but you know, like similar. Hey, Brandanus. Ah, so the dark. Yeah, okay, Kiki. Okay, these are your favorite ones. And dark chocolate speculatius ones. I have to check them out. Do you have a special brand which you like? I think. Also, I did not eat speculatius for ages. I don't eat it often. And I think I never ate speculatius with chocolate. I think. Also at least not that I remember. I have to check it out. I still try to find this toffee with double chocolate, but I guess I'm just too late. Also I did not see any boxes of that. I think I'm just too late. Once it exists, that doesn't mean there are no record of used sauna. Who's are they? Okay, I have no clue about saunas, guys. Also, I also don't, yeah, I don't care who was the first one and who invented it or not. I don't mind it. So, it's fine. It's fine. Okay. So, but I think I know the term Finnish sauna. Also, that I heard. So maybe just like something specific. What are you doing there compared to others? I have no clue. Maybe it's the heat? How hot it is? I have no clue. So I have really no idea. Those aren't even expensive. It's Edeka. Ah, so it's their own label? I have to see if I... I have to see if I find it. I want to eat Speculatius, Eisturmfänger. I have to see if I find them tomorrow. Even so, I want to make tomorrow my own cookies. So, but maybe I can buy them as a backup in case my self-made stuff is not so good. Maybe. Maybe. We're collecting now some surveys before we go over to the Deadlands. Yeah. Oh, and today I exported our Harry Potter adventure, Lego adventure. And interesting is, some of the Music parts got even already muted here on Twitch, but only some, not all. That's really interesting. Also, not like, because on YouTube, everything is just, also the music is just muted. Also, not muted, claimed. Also, that's the difference. But like the whole video, every second is claimed, which was, naja, also, which was clear as the first. I don't care because I don't get anything anyway on the second YouTube channel. And yeah, I mean, it's Harry Potter movie music, so I expected that. But it was really like interesting that on Twitch, only one video, as for now, I don't know if that will, the others will follow, but only some parts are muted. And on, yeah, on YouTube, everything got immediately claimed. Did you try to cook more stuff on the tech? So did you try out different recipes now? And do you feel already better with changing your diet? Hallo Alien, woohoo! Dum dum dum. Where do we have to go? Do you have internet, Beauvray, in your cabin? Nee, oder? Probably not. I think I asked you it already. I don't think so. You said it's like outside. So I assume you don't have there. Do you have a radio? Maybe. Radio maybe. And it's like really far away. Poor. No, but it's good. I mean, I think to relax and just, you know, we have not more. I think it's not a bad thing that you don't have any connection. You can just like really calm down. I buy frozen broccoli and some fresh eggs that I can boil. Yeah, but you can also make with eggs. You can so make so much stuff. You can make scrambled eggs and omelette and sunny side eggs. You could also do it, eggs pair so well with lots of stuff. You can also make pasta with eggs, for example. You could make pasta with eggs and broccoli. You can make really nice sauce. Make spaghetti carbonara, for example. If broccoli can also make nice sauce or salad. Broccoli is super versatile. But I guess if you ask the mighty internet, you will find millions of recipes. Probably. I mean, you can just like make everything. The energy and effort it takes doesn't make much. You think so? Also, okay. Yeah, maybe you have that different approach than I have. You know, even so, let's say take my bolognese today. I started to cook the bolognese. It took more than an hour to just prepare and then cook the sauce. You know, I had to cook like I had to cut lots of vegetables. And you have the meat and. You have to spice everything and you have herbs and you have to cook all and you need wine and I also took some of my chicken stock and I don't know, it took lots of time. And then after that you have to clean the kitchen, of course, and then, you know, like I have to go each time to the kitchen and mix up everything again, etc, etc. But if then later the meal is delicious, then for me it's like more than worth. Also if I make a really nice meal, it has a super taste, then I feel like it was a good effort. And even if it's sometimes maybe not the best, then I'm like, okay, maybe now I learned something and then for the next time we can maybe improve and make it better or take it as an idea for upcoming stuff. But yeah, also since I like to eat, yeah, when it's then getting really delicious and well made, yeah, then I'm happy. And yeah, I'm then also fine with the effort. The only thing what I wish would go faster would be, you know, that you don't have to clean all the time, but I guess it's just part of the, you know, when you do something in the kitchen, yeah, that you have to clean. It would be nice if you could just like make like, you know, like Mary Poppins, like tick, and then da-da, everything is fine. The food I make takes 20 minutes at most. Yeah, but you can also make nice variation of food which in less than 20 minutes. Doesn't have to be always just like, you know, super basic. Pasta is all about the sauce. Yeah, I think so too. Even so, when you have leftover pasta and then roast it in the pan, it's also fine. At least I like that too. This is me too. Yeah, it's not like I cook all the time, like 2 hours, but I just wanted to say I don't mind if it takes longer. You know, because I know that if I put time and effort into the cooking process and I get nice ingredients, then it will also taste better. You know what I mean? So, for example, I find that there's a huge difference if you, for example, get your meat from a local discounter, or if you get it from a good butcher. So the butcher is more expensive. Yeah, that's also a difference. But I usually find that it's also like, you know, tasting much better. Eating like Mary Poppins would be so awesome, yeah, oder? I think for you it would even not even much better with like little mini hexa around. I can imagine that mini hexa does also lots of house decoration. Oh, did I tell you I bought for the cats? I bought cat grass, as which they can eat if they want. And because I was not sure, you know, if Muffin ever saw it or not. So I tried to, I just was like, hey, I bite it. And I was growing that the last week or so. And it looked beautiful. Really, really pretty. It's like really, really pretty. And so I was then placing and now it was like really nice and done. And it was like, okay, now they can have it if they want. So I placed it like, now like really more open where the cats could reach it. And now the last 2 days nothing was there, like, okay, yeah, maybe they don't like it. And then yeah, today in the morning someone, obviously I don't know who it was, someone went and tried, I don't know if they tried the grass, I think they tried, but instead of like munching it, they pulled it out, which ended it like, also the grass is still complete and fine, but they took like the whole earth, like half of it out. Like there was like, outside of the little pot, there was like the complete grass with roots and earth on the side. So, and I don't know, probably they got scared because then they stopped doing anything. So I don't know, I put it now back. Let's see what they will do overnight again. I like my pasta with Wurst and Cabbage. Okay. Why not? This is typical Italian Sunday. Spend a lot of time into cooking. What did you cook today, Ian? But yeah. I just wanted to say, you know, I don't... Also, I just don't mind how. If you want to, don't want to spend so much time in the kitchen, that's fine. It's also okay. I find it usually easier when you cook for someone. Also, you know, like if you have to cook just for yourself, as when you're alone, then I think it's a bit tougher. But when you then at some point maybe family or friends over, you know, then it's a bit easier because then you cook for someone or you cook together and you're... You love cooking? Relaxing? You're... I mean, I'm not like really into super fancy stuff, you know, some people like really this, yeah, you know, like star cooking, so I don't mind it. I find it interesting to see what they can do with some food, but I know I would not like probably enjoy that. I like more, you know, rustical stuff, so... Okay, I wanted to go to the Way Shrine. Achso, yeah. I could just have ported. I thought we have some more stuff to collect here. So how does my survey collection look like now? Okay, it's a list. Oh, I forgot to take something out of the bank. Cooking is more fun when you can do that for... Do it for, huh? If you can do it for someone, do you want to say that, CP?
What do you require of a zombie fragrant employer? You seek a...
So which one did I forget to take? This one. I love baking cakes, but not normal food. I'm not good at normal food, lol. I can make you lovely cake. But do not ask me to cook your chicken. It will not be edible. But making cakes is also awesome. That's a good skill. A really nice one. Which is your favorite cake? What's the difference, Aiden, from the recipe of your grandma? If you want to share it. I don't know if it's like a super duper secret. My favorite is lemon drizzle cake. Okay, wait. I don't know what is lemon drizzle cake. Also I understand lemon and cake, but I don't know what is drizzle. Lemon drizzle cake. Oh, it's just okay. I see. It should just be lemon cake, oder? And on top you have like sugar and lemon coating. Yeah, okay. Okay, then I know what it is. I did not know the English term for it. Just, okay. Yeah, that's tasty. Okay. I had no clue how it's called in also, like, that you have a special term for that. I would say Zitronenkuchen, lemon cake. Yeah, that's nice. That's true. That is true. Yeah. Everything just the same moment. Yeah. Also, you know, also when I like when I was still, you know, a long time ago, also ancient times ago. I mean, now I'm much, much older, but you know, at some point, once upon a time, then I was also I told you already, I was usually cooking, even for myself, I was always cooking more stuff. Also, because I don't know, like Bolognese, etc. I don't know. It's like... To cook just a small portion is tough. So, I usually cook more and then I did freeze it in portions. Even so, I did also not so much. You know, like, as I now nowadays, I put much more effort into cooking and thoughts. But, yeah. You know, after eons of time, opinions or experience can change. And then to make some stuff different. So, for example, a while ago, I tried a frozen pizza. And I have nothing against it, but I did not eat it for quite a long time. And I took the one which I was eating for sure, which I liked a lot, you know, once upon a time. And then I tried and was like, okay, I don't like it anymore. It's just, I don't know. I did not find it really so nice. And I know I liked it a lot. But now, not anymore. No, not a secret. You only put inside chicken livers. Really? Okay, I can imagine you should not taste it when you have it inside the... inside... Also, I'm not a huge fan of liver, to be honest. Some people really like it. I think... liver is always mean. When you like roast liver with, you know, like in a pan with onions, it smells really good. It smells delicious. But when you try liver, it's like, blah, as at least for me. I know some people really like it, but don't get me wrong. I respect it, but I don't like the taste of liver at all. But when you, I can imagine when you put it like in the bolognese, also you probably don't taste so much of it. Oh. Okay. That's pretty unique, yeah. If you make it the right way, liver is so delicious. Maybe I did not really taste a good liver then. Can be. As I have to be honest, it's been a while. Also many years that I tried liver. But I still remember when I tried it, I was like, oh my god. but it's been really long time, so yeah, I did not try it again. Like liver, Maxalatico is one of my favorites. Okay, I would say that sounds like salad with something, but I'm not sure if that's like true. Same like you, but cooking liver with beef 4 hours after. Because of that, I said, if it's like the cooking for so long with lots of different ingredients, I can imagine that it has a different taste. And also gives like maybe a small different note to the sauce. Maxalatico. I will just now Google it. And see what is Maxalatico. Maxalatico. Okay, I have no clue what it is. It looks like an Auflauf? This is something what you put together and into the oven, but I don't understand what's inside. And there's liver inside? In this Maxalatico? Okay, also in Deutsch is Leberauflauf. Okay, so I was not wrong. You eat it to Christmas. It's like a Christmas food. Yeah, okay. Sliver Casserole. Ja. Okay. Achso, ein bisschen sogar hier. Wir have liver paste and sandwiches here. Ja. We have also something that is called Leberwurst. Which I don't like. I don't like that, no. But there are different variations. Also weaker ones, better ones. Ja. Also, Ayan said she, they're using chicken liver. Also, her grandma. But yeah. But you still have your other meat. You put away cooked roasted liver and fat. And smeared on bread. Oha. I guess, Alien, you have to type your recipe down and put it on Discord. Didn't want to go here. Naja, gut. Also fine. Then we go, Alec, here. Collect here the stuff. Then we go to the Deadlands. I hope that the Christmas cookies, which I will try tomorrow, will go well. I hope so. I made lots of dough. So, I hope it will be worth. Then, oh, tomorrow is the server out, oder? In ESO, I think. At 10 again? Or earlier? Because I have now 9 event tickets. I just wanted to, you know, make it to 12. It's not super necessary since the new live festival is easy peasy. And it's not like a big deal to get their event tickets. But still, we want to be efficient. Does Deadlands go to your top 5 zones? No. Also, I like Fargrave. I think Fargrave is really pretty. I think the Deadlands is well made. You know, it's pretty fitting to the Deadlands. But it will not be one of my favorite zones because, yeah. I prefer, also, you know, more pretty nature. I mean, the Deadlands are pretty dead. But for that, what they wanted to achieve, I think they did it really, really good. I mean, it's super fitting to the whole theme of the, you know, of the 1 year long story. And I mean, it's the Deadlands. So you can't really make their, you know, like stuff in like Somerset where everything is beautiful and nice for the elves. So you know what I mean? But Fargrave, I think the city Fargrave is really well made. I love the, you know, like the atmosphere there. And also like the whole feeling of a bazaar. The mix of the, you know, the Deedras and the humans. Pretty cool. But yeah, I think it's hard in ESO to say what is your favorite places. I liked Elsewhere a lot. Some of the, but you know, all have like really pretty spots. For example, Greymoor has pretty spots. Morrowind also. Also the base game. Also, I think ESO in general has some... have great places. And they're beautiful. Do you have, like, favorite zones? Didn't you like Clockwork City? Oh, Clockwork City was also nice. Clockwork City was really, really pretty. Also, that's true, yes. Clockwork City was really cool. And really well made also. And the story of Clockwork City is also really good. 10 to 1 is maintenance tomorrow. Okay. Then I should be good in the morning. Thank you, Tina. Theodil is also pretty, yes. That's true. Theodil is... I found it also quite surprising that it's a really beautiful zone. The only thing that is not so nice in Theodil, it's... I mean, there's a reason for that. It's pretty big, as it's really huge, but... yeah. Does not have so much often, you know, to see. But I think that's for the performance. So Alien, Bovray was asking if you do lots of liver inside the bolognese or only a little bit. So he was asking how much. So like, for example, 100 gram chicken liver and 500 gram minced meat or beef meat or whatever. You know what I mean? So he was asking for advice how much you put inside so he can cook it. Even don't play PvP, yeah. Auridon is also beautiful. That's true, Quant Attack. Auridon is also pretty beautiful. And as you know, I really like Riften. So? But I think overall, ESO has like... many places. I mean, you can see the difference between the newer chapter zones and the older zones. I mean, that's... not like terrible, but... you know, you can see some differences and improvements in the newer ones. But even so, I still find the base game zones are really, really nice in ESO. Really pretty. Mean Mosquitoes. So. Basically, I like Blackwood based on playing Oblivion, but there are too many invisible vaults. That's pretty annoying. That's true. Okay. Then we have here one more treasure map. Agalon, Malabato. Alchemist. Treasure map. I have so many treasure maps. Yeah, Auridon. Make Auridon. Is it done with Wardenfell? Yeah, Morrowind is pretty. So, okay. So we collect this one. And then we will go over to the Deadlands. At first, we will go to Fargrave. And hand in the quest. We have to pick up, I think. I handed it in. We have to pick it up. How's work going, Beaufray? Is it okay? You still feel fine? I went wrong, oder? Can we go here? We use Italian sausage and beef. Italian sausage, really? I always use minced meat. And I use bacon. Sometimes, depends. Today I have bacon here. And I was like, okay, I think I need to use that soon. So I cut there some pieces and put it with also inside. All good? All good, Alien. If only 2 days next week, okay. That's good. Did some of you already put up the Christmas tree? See? It's pretty. Yeah, Auridon is really beautiful. I agree. See, a place like this would be something what I would like to visit. You have a lake, you have a waterfall. Lots of trees, nature. Lights of fire, maybe then tree next week. I saw today several people like posting pictures that they set up their trees and everything. Oh, Deadlands. Your first Far Cry. Also, if you add an E&B, do you play ESO with an E&B? The pack of. I don't think it matters if you use it or not, Beaufray. Also, you know, before you buy not such a good thingy, maybe just make it with the usual meat what you do. But it's a good, I will check it out if I can find something like that, Alien. I have no clue if I can find like good or real Italian sausage here. So, but maybe I try it in the future. If I get something, I will try it out. And we learned secrets.
Complete a job for the Sarathu Tong, and you might. There are. Hexos is really.
You can try to make two, Beaufray. You can make. Maybe make one first just to deliver and see the difference. And then the next time you can make one, and if you like it, you can make one with the liver and the sausage. And see how's that. So you can compare it and see how good it is. So step by step. Are you doing your own pasta, Alien? Or do you buy fresh pasta? Or do you just buy, you know, like regular pasta from the supermarket? I always use Barilla. Usually. At some point I bought some fresh pasta. Sometimes. But I got some which were like okay. It's not terrible, but also not like super good. And I once I had some fresh pasta which was really nice. Asparilla? Nein, Barilla. So, I'm collecting now here for the repeatable quest stuff. don't have the company available in your discounter, Ouvre. I buy fresh pasta, a little bit lazy. My grandmother made it in the house, much better, of course. Yeah, I never tried to make fresh pasta, to be honest. It's like, I think is lots of work to make it good. I think you need probably lots of experience for good dough. And then also to form the pasta, etc. But I guess if you get there some experience, etc., get faster. But I never tried. Maybe someday. If I feel like that. Okay. Oh, good. Is another box? You put red wine in the bolognese, alien? I do. I don't know what alien is doing. So today I put inside red wine, like I think half bottle. And then when it cooked down, I don't know what are the real English terms for cooking, so I'm sorry. When it like cooked down, and the wine was almost done, then I put inside my chicken stock. I tried it today, and it was really good. It was a good idea. And then tomato stuff. But I always make my pasta with red wine. No clue if this like original, but I make it with red wine. Maybe it also depends what kind of wine you take. I don't know. I don't drink wine. Also, I don't drink wine. I just use it for cooking. So, yeah. Aren't you listening to the cooking show all the time? I do, but I still don't know what they say for einkochen oder so. So, I don't think they describe so often what they have to do. Maybe. I don't know. It doesn't mean that I then have to remember always. I did not cook it for a while because I watched already everything from MasterChef. I'm already done. Lord Mancha Molagba. I probably remember more words, like, for example, Gordon Ramsay has now, he makes it on YouTube on his channel. He makes a cooking, I don't know if you call it cooking show, but he's like cooking in 10 minutes. So he has like now a cookbook where he's offering recipes which you can cook in 10 minutes. And in his YouTube channel, he also then shows stuff what you can cook in 10 minutes. I think it's called even Gordon in 10 minutes. I don't know, but it's 10 minutes stuff. And he says there, I think, I don't know. Also in this 10 minutes, he says, I feel like he says 1 million times, beautiful. 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 It's always beautiful. And lovely. Lovely was more his mom, I think, but beautiful, he says really, really, really often. It's beautiful. Yep, beautiful. A lot. And, literally, that he's also saying often. Much better than I do. I find literally is a difficult word. He says it a lot also. But beautiful. Yeah, beautiful. And the garlic, beautiful. Yeah. Then, what does he say? I don't know. He says always like, season. Season it generously, and then he makes like, I don't know, it looks like a mountain of salt, and he's like, or oil or something, and he's like, beautiful. Yeah. But I've always to smile when he says that, always like, oh, it's beautiful, all is beautiful. Beautiful. I always have to smile.
Me, me, me. Me, me, me. Welcome back, my friend.
Phoenix! Welcome back. Me, me, me. Thank you so much for 21 months. Thank you very, very much. Welcome back. How are you doing? Hello, my panda family. Hope all are well. And this is our Xmas panda. Yeah, thank you. How are you doing? Oh, I went here. That's not what I wanted to do. You know what? I don't have time to chat. Hello, white card. Not bad. Awesome.
A new follower.
Thank you for the follow. Me, me, me. Yeah. I love watching Ernst Knam. Very good with chocolate. Here he is, the king of chocolate. Ernst Knam. I never heard about him, I think. I think I only know Joe Bastianich. I don't know him, no. He's German. Lol. I don't know him. Ernst Knam wurde in Deutschland geboren, ist jedoch im Herzen Mailänder. Ach so, und allen bekannt als der König der Schokolade. Nach langen Aufenthalt der Röschel, am Ende nach ich. Ach so, so he's German but living in Italy. Ach so, no wonder I don't know him. I always wanted to see, I saw that Joe was part of MasterChef in Italy. There was, well, I was like interested, and like, yeah. What would be interesting to see how he is different in the Italian show compared to the US show, but I don't understand Italian, so, and I don't think they have probably subtitles, but that would have been interesting to see just because of the difference. Yeah. Because every German knows every German back. Yeah, of course. First repo. So, it's like this I also find funny. In this cooking shows when they're like, this person, especially in America, they have that often. They have like the saying, my heritage, I'm Italian in the 10th generation. I'm like, aha. Yeah. And they're like, I'm true Italian here. And then they're like, you know, they act like they have to know every Italian recipe. Where I'm like, yeah, just because I'm from Germany, I does not mean I have to know any German recipes, or that I have to know how to cook, or that I have to know how to, I don't know, every beer tastes or so. You know what I mean? So, I mean, just because you come from somewhere, it doesn't mean you, as I think, at least it's my opinion, you don't have to know that.
Oh, you're back. I was, ooh. Well, we usually.
Maybe some will know, but I would not know. I mean, I can tell you maybe some German recipes, or, but only some, not all. Yeah. Just because you're from Germany, you don't have to speak German technically. Yes. And I know also one. Okay, I don't know that. I don't even know his name. But I know that Gordon was doing with an Italian guy. That also show where they made like a road trip, I think. I don't know how. What was the name of this guy? I don't remember. You have here the. Boss quest. We go there first. Ernst Knam. Yeah, maybe I have to look him up. And I really did never hear about him. We go now to the boss and complete the next daily repeatable quest. Then we have to see where we have to go next for our. Oh, I think we have to go to Fargrave for the main quest, oder? Ah, ja. Na ja, gut. We can travel back. Have to do Dietrich merchandise. What's Germany like? Asking as American with a thirst to live somewhere else. Naja, different. I don't know. It's probably, I think, when you are from America, I think you go to Europe. Probably some stuff will be different. I don't know where you're living in America, so maybe it could be also that some parts in Europe will be colder than you're used to live. But I would say overall, Europe can be nice. But depends what you want to do, what you're looking for. Just have to remember that Europe is much smaller than America. Much smaller. Also, you know, you can go from one end to the other end in Germany in like, let's say, 8 to 9 hours. Then you are already leaving. And you can go, I don't know, to Netherlands, or France, or Austria, or Swiss, or, you know? So, it's like also pretty cool. So you can like travel a lot and go to many different countries. But you have to know the language. Also, if you don't want to learn a new language, then I would recommend to maybe go for Britain or Scotland, Ireland, you know, like something like that. If you want to be in Europe. If you want to go to Germany, you need to know German. You can, also as a tourist, it's fine. But if you want to live here, then you're... Ooh. Did you ever do the boss? I don't remember this big worm. Maybe you just died too fast. What did I get? Did you get a lead? Yeah, I got a lead, guys. This one here. Oh yeah. Okay, cool. We got again a lead. Germany, like most of Europe, is pretty safe. Bosporus is a nice place to live. Plus, in Europe, you are so close to other cultures geographically. It's very easy to enrich yourself, oneself that way too. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, and yeah. Oh, hi, Futsilui. Yeah, compared to maybe other parts, I would also say we're pretty safe. Yeah, that's true. That's for sure. But also, I think like other parts in the world, when you want to live like in big cities, they're probably pretty expensive. No, sadly. Yeah, okay, so where do we have to go for the quest now? Well described, Quant Attack. Made it much better than I did. when it's like a big question, right? It's maybe easier if you ask directly specific points. Okay, so this is repeatable. Enter Brandfire, bla bla bla. Mädchen named Propaganda. We made it already, oder? Oh ne, we did not. This is a new one here. Go to House Williams. Okay, so we have to go back to Barkwave and talk to the main quest guy. I'm gonna get a job as a hydrologist or some sort of geoscientist outside of the States. Also, I heard that Netherlands and Germany are really good at water and flood control, and I want to see and study that. So yeah, I mean, we could just try and maybe apply for jobs here, and if it works out, then you can come over. Acolytes and Pyres of the Flame. Scour the Deadlands for the members of the Order of the Waking Flame that have lost their way, and for new postulates who unknowingly seek the heat of devotion. We near the ignition of the Prince of Destruction's plans. Our work until this point has been mere kindling to the tasks that lie ahead. To this end, our recruitment of efforts need to longer be restrained. You are authorized to use whatever means, be there for something, violence or intimidation, to complete the goal of adding to our ranks. Fear not for any recruit brought to the Brandfire Reformatory, we will leave a proud and valiant servant of Mehrun Stegen. I wait for report success. Okay, we have now two quests there. Okay, I run to the Wraith Shrine and then from there we go over back to Fargrave, completed quest, and then go to Madame Wim. Okay, so we go now here, and then do to Madame, then hand in the daily, maybe get a new one, I don't know. Go here around and around and around. Hello.
Well,
all completed.
Whomever built, heard of.
You mean not drop any? So really unmotivated. I made 10 times white gold tower today for spell power healing stuff, but nothing, and I tried every day. Would it not be easier if you just get key fragments and open the door? No? Also, I would make that. Well, I made that back in the days. When I wanted to get spell power cure for my healer, I bought key fragments, lots of them. And then I went into the dungeon, and then at the start of the dungeon you go to the side and there is the door which you can open with key fragments, and I open chests. Yeah, that's how what I made. Let me see, I don't even know what parts we got. I did not do that for a long time, but when I wanted to get that stuff for my healer, he still wears spell power cure. See, I got the headpiece, hands, legs, feet, neck, ring, healing stuff, flame stuff. Yeah, yeah, you can. Wait, I will show you. I can show you that. Wait, before we go now, I can show you that. So, what you do is, ist. Wait. So, let me out. Ach so, now I know what's wrong. So you have to go. You can buy key. Also either if you want, you can earn key fragments in the Imperial City if you want to. That's of course an option if you want to earn them yourself. Or, so wait. Or you go to the guild traders and buy key fragments with gold. That's also an option. Then you go to the right gold tower. Then put the key fragments in your inventory. Also the, I think they're called key fragments. And then, I think I even made a, I think I have even on my website something about it. Yeah. And then you go.
My patience grows thin, sister. We've had our differences, but when have you ever known me to be wrong?
Here.
Yes. Yes, I suppose.
Then you go here. Or you ask me for key fragments. I need to get rid of mine. You can sell them pretty good, Redslove. Then you go here inside and open this one. The Daedric Embers Trophy Vault. This needs 150 key fragments when you go there each time. Also need there some. But that's a good option. Wait, maybe I have even some here. Wait, I can maybe show it to you so you see how it's working. I'm not sure if I have enough key fragments. I have, see? So, see these ones? Yeah, also they're not so cheap. For 220, I would say, is average. So. So. Okay, I've done 150. So you see, now it's active, the door. Yeah, as I have, you need for this one, for the doors in the Imperial City, you need less. But for this one here, you need more. You need 150. And also in the other dungeon here, you need also 150. So you click. And you go inside. And then you open this one here. Fuck. Achso, yeah. I already. Okay. I have automatically looting on. But yeah. So if I had now more keys, also more key fragments inside, I could open the chest more often. So you need to have always, also depends how often you want to open the chest. But let's say you want to open a chest. I have no clue. 10 times. Then you have to have 10 times 150 keys with you. Yeah. But yeah, you just need key fragments. You see, it's written Daedric Ember keys. So maybe some of you remember. Once upon a time, in ESO, there were lots of different keys. I think I have even some old keys left still. I believe. Let me see. I think I have some old keys left from back in the days. I see here. These are the old keys. Daedric Embers, Daedric Shackles, then Dark Aether. These are old, really monstrous tools. So back in the days, they had it was really, or this one also, was super complicated. Or not super complicated, but you had to remember that each door in the Imperial City, they were like, see here, like each door in the Imperial City, here's this one, Monstrous Tools Trophy Vault, Clawed Trophy Vault, they all had their own unique currency to open the doors. And at some point they changed it. So that is like only just key fragments, which just convert to whatever you need and go inside, which makes it much easier. Tian 10k Telva is max provide. That's true. If you want to also farm like outfit style pages from that one alien, you should have, also here, you should have like 10,000 Telva stones from your bank or equipped if you have. That will give you then much higher chances to get stuff. That's true. That is true. I agree. Let me check something. I even made I made a guide for that here, alien. In case that you want to see that. Hey, they can show you that one. What did they not port? Here. Yeah, trophy vaults. I wrote their guide. How trophy vaults work, how you earn key fragments, where to go, how many keys you need, where are the keys, bla bla, und so. What you can find, where you find, in which, I also listed where, which sets you will find in which trophy vault, so you can see what you need there. Also, which styles you can find. So, there you go. I wrote it a while ago. Yeah. And you have also here a map where you can find the trophy vaults, where they are, and what you need for each thing. And I think it should be good. I hope I thought about everything. Yeah. But yeah, check it out. See? I wrote it in August. There you go. It's been a while. And I wrote it because I think for the Sifkin style pages and Nibanese style pages. So, oh. I think Sifkin. Yeah. Yep.
Finest merchandise around.
I've got what you need.
The NPC walked into you and cancelled your port. Oh, what a mean NPC! Ay, 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 ay.
I have many fine goods.
It's not nice. Okay. So we continue off the main quest. So we can maybe make one part today. So, but yeah. Bit of delay, but I hope it will help you, alien. And maybe you can trade with Retzlov for the key fragments. You don't need him, Retzlov. Hello, Tom Tom. You go in a group, you can share anything. Yeah, of course, Hakonnen. That's of course also possible. But if you just don't want to run the dungeon and just want to, you know, try a different way. I was pretty happy that I could just, like, you know, go there and got lucky with the drops. You're welcome, alien. You're welcome. Welcome back, Beaufré. You're welcome. Yeah, I did not know that also a long, long time ago. They also tried to you know, like farm the tower, also the dungeon, but it of course takes a bit of time. And back in the day, the dungeon was also much more difficult. They lowered the difficulty quite a lot, as far as I know. And yeah, so I was super happy. And someone told me, hey, go here, take the keys. And I was like, oh yeah. And then I bought lots of keys. Also I really, maybe check Tamriel Trade Center alien. And see for keys. And yeah, maybe you get lucky. Maybe. Yeah, I know Hakonnen, I know, but yeah, maybe she can now do both. But if you have a group and they help you, you know, like when I wanted to get Medusa stuff, and then Tina, Vulo, and Tobi helped me, that was also super nice. Indeed, yes. That's indeed true, if you have a group which is helping you.
Master, show Lirinth the twisted rod. It's important, I'm sure of it.
I assumed we'd find answers here in Fargrave. Some way to salvage the opportunity denied me at Forge Grief. But no. Even Madame Wim seems at a loss as to the location of Deadlight.
Maybe this will help. We found this twisted rod in a cave of the summit.
Let me see. It contains a dormant enchantment of some sort. It feels unpleasant. And the magic, it smells like your Daedrat. I will keep the rod and study it as time permits. Unfortunately, I do not think it is related to Sister Seldina.
How do we find this hidden realm called Deadlight? Now, your Medusa erfahrung was with Volo, Tobi and Brick. Ach so. Okay, but all the other dungeon ones were with you. So, so there you helped. I know the Khajiit Mobos.
I'm not sure yet, but the answer will become clear soon enough. I should not have gotten angry, little mortal. You have helped me a great deal, and you certainly helped Fargrave and Nirn by destroying the Riven Cataclysm. Take this as a recompense.
Oh, your pictures with the cats in the dryer were super cute, Tina. What, was the clothing still warm?
The secrets I seek rest with Sister Seldina. She still has the means to create more cataclysms, so the danger to Fargrave and Nirn remains. We must ascertain the location of Deadlight and this hidden stronghold the Bladebearers heard mentioned.
Do you have any idea how we learned the location of Deadlight?
Everything I know about Deadlight is rumor and conjecture. It is a plane that suffered some great cataclysm in the ancient past. A realm forgotten and lost to time. I had hoped that Madame Wim would know more, but she claims the place is a mystery.
Think used for sending his Bladebearers to scour the Deadlands for Sister Seldina.
Interesting. The Bladebearer clan scouts are indeed competent. Perhaps they can find the trail where we have thus far turned up nothing. Very well. Find Rinkaius and see what he has learned.
Achso,
meanwhile,
Rinkaius.
I have my own research Rinkus. To conduct.
Okay.
I asked Rinkaius to meet us here in Fargrave. You should find him in the Plaza of Portals. See if his scouts learned anything useful, or if he requires your assistance. In the meantime, I have investigations of my own to attend to.
Can you tell me about your investigations?
Much of what I study is beyond the limits of your mortal comprehension. But I suppose you have earned some insight into my grand purpose. I plan to study the twisted rod you gave me. I also want to ask the Anchorite about the events at Fort Grief.
At Fort Grief, Sister Seldina and Valkyna Snorkos had some sort of falling out.
Did you not see that coming? I'm surprised they remained allies for as long as they did. Valkyna's Nokvraz obviously hated providing support to a mortal, and Sister Seldina clearly despised having Daedric oversight.
Does it mean we don't have to worry about Valkyna Snokos anymore?
Certainly not. Nokvraz was attempting to figure out how to build his own cataclysm, you do recall. But we should strike at the waking flame while it is in disarray. Find their hidden stronghold, learn what I require, and then do what you must.
I think the twisted rod could be important.
Any tool can find a purpose in the correct hand. I sense dormant magic within the rod. And something about the energy reminds me of your Daedrat.
Arokster think the rod is important. Genau.
He does he? Interesting. We have seen that the Daedrat's senses are highly attuned. Perhaps there is more to the rod than I originally suspected. I will study it and see what I can learn.
What do you want to ask the Anchorite?
Both Rinkaius and the Anchorite mentioned how she disrupted the Cataclysm's power, giving you the opportunity to defeat the Incarnate and destroy the machine. She claims not to know how she accomplished that. Perhaps I can help her understand.
You're not going to hurt her, Oda?
I only want to hear her story. Ask her questions. She has indicated that when she tries to access her forgotten memories, the mask causes some amount of discomfort. But I will not personally inflict any harm upon her. Do you not trust me, mortal?
Okay. Arox is running away. He completed Red City of Ash 2 for the first time. Awesome! Congratulations! Congratulations! And did you like it? That feeling long time ago, yeah. Was nice. The good thing about getting stuff from the vault is comes in purple. That's true, Harkonnen. This is true. Can we talk first to the... Achso, did I miss her? Was she there? Talk to the anchor, right? Where was she? Oh, oops.
Sorry, I was just thinking. Ever since we returned from Fort Grief, I've been having strange visions. More forgotten memories bubbling to the surface. At least, I hope that's what it is. Some mortals who linger in Fargrave for too long go insane.
You want to talk about these new memories?
Twice now, something triggered a return of memory. First when the Collector examined my mask, and then when I disrupted the Cataclysm. But I just see fragments, nothing clear or precise. Funny, but I think the amulet has something to do with it.
The amulet that the old seer Eligian gave you?
Yes. Whatever I did to the Cataclysm, and it was me, I'm certain of that, even if I don't understand how. It also charged the amulet. Like what happens to a Lucent when you place it in a Dynamis font. Except this energy draws out my memories.
Can you tell me what you're remembering?
As I said, fragments. Glimpses of clarity in a haze of forgotten moments. I feel loneliness. I see a dark, enclosed space. A flash of blinding light. Nothing very useful or definitive, I'm afraid. Maybe Lirinth can help me make sense of it.
Okay. So. Now we have to talk to Rinkius, or however he's called.
Hail, Rinkaius!
Rinkaius!
We found it!
Report, what have you uncovered?
You were correct. The mortal Daganists have broken with Vulcanar's Nakvraz. They retreat to a hidden stronghold in Deadlight.
Where is Lirinth, mortal? As you heard, the Bladebearers have found Sister Seldina and her cultists. The Waking Flame has nowhere left to run.
You found a stronghold? You found Deadlight?
I forced a cultist to tell me about Deadlight. It's a broken realm, apparently destroyed by Mehrunes Dagon eons ago. He gave it to the cult and they built a stronghold there. A clever hiding place. But the portal to the realm requires a special key.
And where's the portal located?
That we have not yet determined. But I have a plan. You must follow one of the groups of cultists, trail them to the portal, and take their key. If the portal key works like the keys to Fargrave, you'll also need the code to operate it.
Alright, I will go into the Deadlands and track group of cultists. What about you?
We will search for more cultists. Here, the locations my scouts found in the Deadlands. I suggest you start in the Sever. Find a key in the portal and we'll rendezvous before the assault begins. And take the Daedrat with you. His smell offends me.
So, Arok?
Let us find these mortal cultists and finish with them, Master. Then we can wreak vengeance on the traitorous Nokvraz.
Sister Seldina first. We will deal with Vulcan's Nokvraz soon enough.
As you say, Master. I remain in your debt and will do as you command. My nose will guide us. My rage will drive us. And my fury will freeze the cultists in their tracks.
And my fury. He's awesome. I really like him. Dim-di-dim. So, by the way, guys, if you would like to join the... our weekly trial, go for it. There's still slots open. And yeah, if you want to join, Sign up it. Was ist ein Upgrade? Sooner than later. You're still missing lots of people. So. Do we have to go now here? Search the cultist site. Oh wait. Oha. He's strong, oder? Let's see. He's a blindfold, like I have.
Warhead for the spike.
I should have maybe called. Should have maybe called my friend Bastian. He looks so cool, oder? This boss. Oh, no, now he doesn't look cool. Go away! Ignore me! That was our. Get back. Let me in peace. Stop the mobbing.
To destroy me.
They killed first of these dudes. I think they are wandering bosses, right? Yeah. They are walking around, exactly, yeah. Did it tell yesterday I finished finally my ESO Winter Steam Room? Ooh! Nice! It's awesome. Which location did you decorate?
Do your worst, mortals, for I shall do mine.
I can take Bastian outside if I forget him again. Did they reset the stuff? Yep. Okay, now it's working again. Two healers and 60 DS are still needed for the next trial. Okay, that's a lot. That's a lot. Whew. Hey, Footsie Louie, did you help? Housing's very bad for my bank. Yeah, that cost a lot of coin, right? Is there also bought a Proud Spire Manor for in-game gold? Ooh, awesome! Congratulations! 1,000 crowns from Darko today. I invested DLCs for dungeon. Nice! Congratulations! No chance, I'm the cleaner.
Caius spoke true. This place reeks of the mortal cultists.
Yeah, the personality is pretty cool.
That's over with, I suppose.
So, summons to Deadlight. Brothers and sisters in the waking flame. The Citadel of Deadlight has served as well as a temple. Novitiate and headquarters. Our Lord, Maroon Stagan, saw fit to visit his blessed destruction upon this unfortunate plane, and he gave Deadlight into our keeping as a sign of his favor. The time has come for Deadlight to serve its final purpose as an impregnable retreat where we can prepare for victory. Hidden within this secluded realm, we'll bring our Lord's incarnates to life. Not just one living disaster, but an army of them. We must now make Deadlight a fortress without a door. The portals leading to other bases and realms are to be served. Save one. The western gate on the river of lava beyond the blood pit. This portal will remain open, secured by key and cipher so that those who can join us in Deadlight can complete the journey. Until we seal the gate, it will be guarded by a potent ward against Daedric beings. We can no longer trust others who serve our Lord Maroon Stagan. They are jealous of our success and will displace us if we allow them to. With or without a portal key, they shall be shut out. Come to Deadlight, my brothers and sisters. Our final task is ahead.
Now we know where the portal is, Master, but it's warded against beings such as myself. Prudent, but annoying.
Saved 1,000 crowns. That's a lot. That's a lot. You've already plans for the house, Quantitech? Any ideas what you want to do? So. We go here?
I am not afraid of you.
So which way do we go? Here. Ow. Ow.
That should come in handy.
That should come in handy. Are you already looking forward to the next event, guys? The New Life Festival? I like the New Life Festival a lot. Even so, you know, I know the quest already, but still, I like the event. Here we go. This way around. Ooh! What is a fire skeletons? Nee.
Someone got to these cultists before us, Master.
Ah. Ow! I like the new life, but there are too many events in ESO. Ah. I mean, the good thing is, if you already did the event in the past, the only thing what you have to do is, also if you just want to get event tickets, make one quest per day. So then you can take it easy. Devastator Tatriax, return to Deadlight Citadel at once. As I recall, you have not employed one of the portal keys before. To unlock the portal in Deadlands, line up the symbols on the key as shown in this diagram. Keep the cipher well hidden. Do not carry a portal key and the cipher at the same time. If you believe you are about to be captured, destroy the scroll. The key is useless without a proper cipher. Our enemies grow bold. For now, we must retreat and regroup. Let them search for us in vain while we prepare the next wave of glorious incarnates.
That's the cipher we need, Master. Perhaps Rinkaius's plan will work after all.
Chaplains are so cute, yeah, they are. That next thing is New Life, it's so easy, yeah. But I know what you mean. I mean, we talked already about it. I think also, if it would slow down, I would probably prefer. But yeah, on the other hand, no one is forcing us to participate also, right? But yeah, my collector heart can't also say I don't do anything. So it's tough. We have to go here. Okay. I went down to the way shrine because we have to go to this place so we can just port. But yeah, I like on the new life festival the quests because they're short and yeah, I mean it's a nice idea, you know, that you learn from each of the races in Tamriel how they celebrate. So yeah, even so, you know, I can understand when you already participate in this event since 2016, it can grow a bit old. Ah, here. Okay, we already went here, but go again. Yeah, anniversary event is even better. Just eating a cake. That's the best one. That's the best one, buffet. I mean,
someone beat us to them. Check anyway. Maybe we'll find something important.
I would say anniversary is my favorite. You know, if you can just do any daily what you want and get event tickets by eating a cake, it's like the less intrusive event when they make it like that, because you can just do what you like, so you know, like do crafting or dungeons or PvP, whatever is your piece of cake, you can do that, participate in the event, you can do more if you want, or you just eat a piece of cake and ignore the rest. So I would say that's like also, I mean, it's my favorite. Yeah.
An intact portal key. If we align the symbols properly, it should open the way to Deadlight. We have what we need, Master. The Deadlight portal lies to the west beyond the Blood Pit.
Anniversary event is a bit too easy for me. I'm so gaga that I lost every time at least minimum 2 tickets because we're gonna have full tickets. Yeah, also luckily, usually since I use this, you know, I have here the toolbar and I see here my event tickets. I usually, before I do anything, check here. Also, when I log in, I usually check here how many event tickets do I have before I do anything. Also, this is what I usually do. Even so, in all the years, it happens for sure once or twice. I mean, this year once, that I wasted a ticket. But usually, I check on my toolbar first before I participate. I'm like, okay, what do I have? This? Good. So, but yeah, it can happen easily. I know what you mean, yeah. Happened to me too. New life is nice because it's winter time and fits perfect with the season. Yeah. I love that it's like the new life festival, that it's in East March and you know there's snow and I like Breda, you have the meat and you know it's like connected to celebration and winter and everything, so it's pretty cool. I could write it all over my monitor how many I have, it would happen soon. So by the way guys, do you want that we celebrate this year our guild anniversary again? Because soon. I mean, last year we made the pictures, the year before I forgot it. And the first year we celebrated. Here. 15th of December. We have our celebration. So it would be Wednesday, which is maybe not so nice for many people. But we could maybe then make the weekend. So Saturday maybe, that we, the 18th. So just some days later that we make there, that we meet again for a group photo. Oder? Celebrate! Celebrations are always good. It would be nice. How could we say no to the question? Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Okay. And then I can maybe announce it that we make it then on the 18th. And I still have to think what we do for the stream. Because we have our 3-year Twitch partner anniversary also soon. On the 6th of December. And I still have to think what we can do special.
Locked and warded against Daedric incursion. These mortals are more resourceful than I imagined.
You did well to find this place, Rinkaius. Ah, mortal. Let us confer.
Good. I was worried about you out there on your own.
On your own? Who is Aerox the Mutilator, chopped Ogrim Spittle?
Can you go down from the horse, please? Thank you.
Since you found your way to this portal, I assume you also recovered a portal key and the cipher necessary to activate it?
Si.
Very good. And I also assume that you heard Rinkaius? Sister Saldine awarded this portal not just to prevent my entry, but any other Daedric entity as well. Neither I, nor Rinkaius, nor Aerox will be able to step through this portal.
It leaves me in Anchorite. What do you need us to do exactly?
Learn whatever you can about the Cataclysm and Sister Saldina's plans. Then I suppose you will want to kill Saldina for the sake of Fargrave and Nirn. Just keep it.
I was seeing an important conversation.
Since you found your way, very good. Learn whatever. Did I say I was concerned? Just watch her. Neither we nor the Anchorite know what her memories will eventually reveal. Who she really is. None of us may like the answer. Go. We will wait here. Try not to destroy anything I may want to examine later.
Love Aerox is the cutest murder puppet ever. Aerox and Rinkaius are two of my favorite Deadland NPCs. Yeah, they make some really cool NPCs here. I agree.
I'm ready when you are.
Lead
the way, friend.
Before I now continue with the quest, I will end the giveaway, guys. So.
Attention, attention, my friends. We are about to end our giveaway. If you still want to enter, please type exclamation mark panda in the chat. We will draw the winner in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good luck, everyone. Good luck. So. Popliu! 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 Wow! Hi! Really? Congratulations, Popliu! Please speak up in chat and let me know on which platform you are playing. Yes, thank you. Yeah. On which platform are you playing for PLU? On PC, Xbox or PlayStation? Playing on an oil platform. Can be? You're on PC? Okay. So what would you like to get? You can choose from a Torchbuck pet, a purple grub pet, red crab pet, 1500 crowns, or Blackwood. Did you already decide? We have crowns? Yeah, sure. Okay. Then, let me get the key for 1,500 crowns for you. For PC. So, one moment. So, crowns for Popliu. So, I whisper you now on Twitch with the key. So, hello, here is your key for 1,500 crowns for PC. You know it's working? Go over to the ESO webpage, log into your account, there you can redeem the code, and then you're rich. Like, super rich. For a moment. Congratulations. Congratulations. Woo. Oh, that's new. Oh my god. This is new, oder? Do you see that in chat? Oh, I did not even know that's possible. That we get a message in this from the store. Someone bought something from our merch store, my friends. Oh my god. Oh, that's so cool. I don't even know that it's working. Yeah. That's cool. Is it true? We never got a message like that. It's like for the first time. Let me check. I have no idea. I didn't even know that it's working. That you can make a message on stream. I had no clue. Oh yeah. That's really true. It's not a lie. Oh yeah, thank you very much. You get today still, guys. If you buy today, you can still use the code if you want. It's on Discord. I posted also everywhere else, but if you want, you can use the code TIANLINE and then you will save 20%. So if you use this code, you can save a bit of coin. That's not it, but I'm glad to be the first of the first from your store. Thank you. That's really appreciated. You're also the first one who bought that glass. By the way, you're the first one who will be receiving that glass at all. The Panda Adventurer glass. I hope you will like it, Phoenix. I wanted to try to buy a sample myself. I did not do that yet. But yeah, you are the first one who got that one. Yeah. I hope you like it. Hope you will like it. Thank you. It's really cool. Yeah. Yeah. And you bought it from the extension at the bottom. That's also new. Also, yeah. Awesome that it's working. Thank you. That's really cool. I had no idea. Now we learned something together. That's really awesome.
Deadlight.
Enter the portal, infiltrate Deadlight Citadel.
This is Deadlight? It feels familiar.
Familiar? This thingy is huge. Look at that, guys. I have to talk to her.
Lirinth and Rinkaius told me about this place. Mehrunes Dagon chased some long-forgotten enemy to this realm and laid waste to the plain. Then he awarded it to his mortal cultists, and they built a citadel here. It seems familiar.
Familiar? You've been here before?
I don't know. It's just a feeling. I'm getting those kinds of impressions all the time now. Like the dam has cracked and the memories are spilling out.
Come on. I'm talking, Bastian.
Lirinth and Rinka. I don't know. Nothing that will help us find Sister Seldina or another Cataclysm, if that's what you're hoping. It's just a feeling. Let's keep moving. We should search for a way into the Citadel. And let's try not to alert the entire fortress that we're here.
I lifted panda glass to your health. Yeah, I thought I will get some of the glasses because I really like tall glasses. So I thought I will also maybe order some and get them in before testing. Deadlands need to be hire proper electrician. All those lightning bolts seem to be dangerous. Indeed, yeah. They can be dangerous. Oh, by the way, guys, next week on Thursday is our movie evening. And we watch Harry Potter, the second part. So if you want to join us, you are welcome. You need, if you want to watch, also, if you can, if you want, join us when you have Prime and it's near Prime included. Or you can also follow along when you, know, like have the movie available on a different streaming platform or at home. And I think we probably will complete next week Lego Harry Potter also. Year 1 to 4.
This looks like an archive of some sort. Let's see if it contains anything that can help us.
Attack!
Attack! Bastian counts as a friendly acquaintance. Potter time? Wait, I'm playing Potter in the Deathland Halls on PlayStation? Really? Is it still... Do you have it at, as a CD there? Yeah, probably, oder? How does it play now, nowadays? Give me a second.
I trust the vision of our glorious leader.
Yeah, you have the disc, okay. But someone was asking a new player if he should buy bank space or not. Someone told him no. I said that you need long-term, anyway, inventory as also bank space. I would probably... What do you think, guys? I mean, he started to play, but still, I mean, I don't think it makes a huge difference when you buy it, but... Sooner or later you buy it. Also, you need it. I mean, you need more inventory as also bank space. And there's anyway not so much what you need to buy nowadays. I mean, back in the days, when you did not get the free mount, I would have said, get the mount first. Because you need that one, but since they get now a mount for free, the first one, yeah, then, you know, there's not much what you need to get with money, oder?
That says Emperor Morikar personally ordered Ella Giant to design the cataclysm for Mehrunes Dagon.
How could you live without some bank space, especially you don't have ESO Plus here? Always go for inventory and inventory management online. Need bank space account, but it's always welcome. More space is always better, yeah. Okay, now I close again my chat. This is also one reason I always usually don't look at the chat, so I don't get sidetracked from questions. So, but yeah, I would. Also, the first thing what I bought was a mount, since yeah, we had to buy one. So I saved my first 10,000 gold went into a horse, and it was not so useful, I would say, because yeah. My horse was not like really trained a lot, which means it was faster to walk. So it was much faster walking than using the mount at this point of time. But still, I bought it. And then I had a horse. And was a proud owner of a horse. And then I started to increase my inventory space and bank space. Almighty High Priest of the Waking Flame, I'm writing to make you aware of certain truths that I concealed from you before. Be sure that I know my place in the Order. I've acted only in direct accord with Mehrunes Dagon's commands. When last we met, you questioned me about the father of my child. I told you he was guard captain, ordered to lay with me by our emperor. It was a lie. My child's father is a Morikar, Emperor of Cyrodiil. Morikar, Emperor of Cyrodiil. I became Morikar's consort in obedience to Mehrunes Dagon, who appeared to me in a dream and instructed me to bear a child for the Emperor. He also commanded that no one was to know the truth of her parentage, not even you. I reveal this now because next step in our plan has been shown to me. I am to have a role in my child's upbringing, to help raise and protect her until the day arrives that she fulfills her destiny. Oh, that's probably the anchorite, oder? My work in Cyrodiil is done. I am now called Deadlight to assume responsibility for the novices there, but I will be ready when you send word. I will drop everything to help care for my daughter. In the name of Lord Dagon and the Longhouse Empress, Desastrix Seldina. Oh! So, Seldina is probably then the mother from her. Cast all the characters didn't get this pets and other stuff. Yeah, but you can still unlock it, Onyx. Also, if you make now a new character, you can still get the stuff. Also, if you want to get unlock the costumes and the dog and whatever there is, make a new character and you will unlock the things. Then you have it too. Also, you can have all three costumes, etc. Just make new characters and level them to 50. Make several characters and level them to 50. There are three costumes and two pets. I believe. I made a video about it. Surprise. But it's been a while, so. But you can watch it there. There I list all the stuff what you get it for each level. Question that Proud Horse is now used by any character because not so much space in the guild house, but they serve to be there. No? The horse is not being used for any character, Orakan. That's true. I don't have also space in the guild house. But I could place it probably in a different house, maybe. But yeah, I did not use that for a long time.
Sister Seldina bore a child to Emperor Morikar? Because she thought Mehrunes Dagon told her to? That's crazy, isn't it?
By the way, there will be a donkey someday, which increased the inventory by 5. Oh, it's like the piggy and stuff. Oh, it's so cute. I love donkeys. A donkey might not be the most glamorous pack animal, but it's certainly the hardiest and most sure-footed. Totting heavy loads through desert mountains and tundra without complaint. So it will give you a dirty look and might nip if you turn away. How did you find it? Okay, it's not here. Also, I so far have the piggy for extra inventory space and the rat. Then with the donkey. The rat is super cute. Wait and see, it's really cute. How did you stumble over that, crazy? When you, if you want to level fast, Onyx, during the new life festival, there's again double XP. As now is not a bad time because double XP during new life festival, then you get double XP during an end of March again, Jester's Festival, and double XP also then April in anniversary event. Is it listed in the wrong category or what? So. But yeah, you know, just get training gear and you can prepare that now. You can craft training gear for your character and get some XP potions and everything. If you want to have everything, yes, I believe. I mean, wait, I can give you the video and you can watch it. So here are all the level up rewards listed. There you go. And then and here you have a video for how you can prepare your character you know, for best amount of XP. Also, it's a bit older, but it's still working like that. So get training gear, then get XP potions. You should have a lot just from, like, you know, logging in everything. And yeah, then you should be good. Then with the, and because all stacks, so like training gear, you get bonus XP. Then you take XP potions plus then from the event the boost. Then you can have like lots of bonus stuff. You know what I mean? Like when you get, for example, a potion for 150 bonus XP, plus 100% from the event, plus training gear, etc. That like makes it fast. Your voice sounds different there. It's, yeah. It's been a long time. I mean, it's like the XP boost is from 2017 and 2018. Yeah, I think I had in both videos probably different microphones. It's much older and different. Yeah, you should watch one of my first videos from 2016. It's even weird. So, yeah, also I find it already weird to listen to my own voice, but to listen to my own voice and all the videos is even more like strange. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Crazy. I'm lurking. Watch these. Okay. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and write a comment. So. While our experiments at Fort Grief have proven that the Riven Catalyst works and produces viable incarnates, the process remains slow and difficult. Sister Seldina has made it clear that certainly that creating one incarnate at a time and failing outright in all too many attempts is unacceptable. Lord Maroon's Dagon desires an army of living disasters, not a mere handful. I examined the blind seer's designs and identified a number of refinements that should drastically improve our success rate by reducing the incubation period. Under my direction, our mages have collaborated in the construction of a 1/4 scale and model of what we call the improved catalyst. The model has performed well in trials so far. The next step is to build a full-sized version and test it with Dremora subjects. I'm confident that the new design will finally enable us to fully implement Sister Selina's vision and numbers of Lord Dagon requires. Okay. Can I never read here anything without disrupting of some people? The guys here don't have any manners, oder? No manners at all. The Order of the Waking Flame welcomes all who seek to remake their lives. We come to Maroon's Dagon's service from many lands and different walks of life, and yet in the eyes of the mighty prince, all that we once were is of no importance. Brokenness, failure, disappointment, grief, it matters not. What Lord Dagon teaches us is how to use the things we are given. Allow me to tell you my own story, my novices. This is my testament. When I was young, and it does seem very long ago, I was abandoned by unworthy parents. I found shelter at the Priory of the Golden Staff. Followers of Magnus, God of the Sun and Great Architect, they cared for me and educated me. For a time I was happy there. The acolytes of the Priory taught me of Magnus' grand design for the Mundus and his disappointment and the flaws introduced into his creation. One old monk even showed me forbidden texts that revealed a darker design. Some of the Magna G once sought a tool to unmake what had been made wrong, in order that it could be remade in accordance with the architect's plan. This confused me. The world was sweet and young in my eyes, and I did not see how it would be in any kind of mercy to undo it. Then in my 16th year, the Reach Horde of the Black Drake came, bringing his war against Tyvok. The Reach Folk burned my priory. They slaughtered my brothers and ravished my sisters, before slaughtering them too. By mere chance, I survived, only to be dragged away as a captive to the Reachfolk. For months, they kept me, a helpless drudge in their camp, and I earned the truth of the world's flaw. Suffering is all that awaits us. When the Horde finally broke up, my Reach captors simply discarded me, destroyed my home, my family, unmade it, so I ran. But I held on to my anger, my thirst for vengeance, and I recalled the story of the Magna G and the tool that could make this flawed world, Maroon's Dagon, Prince of Destruction. I thought of his followers in the Order of Waking Flame and found truth in their teachings that had been hidden from me. In that truth, I began to see a way to enact my vengeance on this imperfect world. And so I worship our Lord and Master and work diligently every day to see his will done. For now I know that only through Maroon's Dagon will the perfect work of great architect and the hope of the Magna G be brought into the beings.
Sister Seldina worships destruction because she sees Maroon's Dagon as a way to repair the design of Magnus by destroying the world.
Yeah.
So they forced Elegion to have visions and create the Cataclyst as part of some deal between the Longhouse Emperors and Maroon's Dagon. But when Morikar wanted to ensure that his heirs ruled the world, Seldina wants to see the world destroyed.
It sounded like the perfected the catalyst process.
Yes. Can you believe it? They think they can make more of those terrible incarnates, and faster too. But have they built this new device, or do we still have time to stop them?
What do you make of Sister Seldina's testament?
She believes that Maroon's Dagon will destroy the world with fire in order to remake it. After suffering at the hands of the Reach, she took up with Emperor Morikar and joined the Waking Flame. Like she was trying to remake herself as well.
Sister Seldina also believes she gave birth to Emperor Morikar's child.
Right. A daughter. I suppose she'd be Emperor Leovic's half-sister. Have you heard of anyone coming forward with such a claim? I'm not totally current on happenings in Tamriel, but even in Fargrave we hear rumors. Come on,
Also, I'm pretty sure she is the daughter. Not because I know it, but you know, that would be like the classical twist in every movie or story, you know? Where you have like surprise. Yeah. I don't know it, but it would be now my guess that would like just fit. Oder? Okay, if you already know it, then don't say it. But if you don't know it, you can guess with me.
I've seen this place.
It's like it might be her. I haven't played from it all. Yeah, because of the, you know, all the mysterious around her.
To the altar. Can you take a look, please?
Pictures. So, here. Altar.
That altar and my amulet. I wonder. Hey, I've got an idea.
What idea?
I had an idea, and then suddenly, the memories are overwhelming. I see other people. Hear their voices. They're filling the room. Yes, I've been here before. The amulet. It's like it's singing to me. I want to try something.
What are you going to do?
The power I summoned to deal with the Riven Cataclysm. I think I can do that again.
Yeah?
The amulet reacted when I did that before, when I was focusing on the Cataclysm. This time, I want to focus on the amulet. I think it will answer me.
How?
By unlocking everything this mask has been keeping from me. I remember things that aren't here now. A totem in the stands, a starry globe, something in the mural. Watch closely when I concentrate on the amulet. I think you might see them too.
Okay.
If you see any of the items I mentioned, move closer and examine them. It's too much. Do you see them? Hurry and take a closer look.
Ach so. Hier? Beachblatt Totem.
Do you know why I brought you here, Novice Maraid?
I do not, revered sister.
Because I could not leave you in isolation any longer. You must know the truth. You are the daughter of Emperor Morakar, and I am your mother. We will finish your training here. Do not disappoint me.
Okay, so we were right.
When Magnus saw the mortal world was flawed, he abandoned its creation. Foolishly, the other gods proceeded and doomed us to suffering. Learn this well. Joy is an illusion. Love is a lie.
What became of Magnus, Mother?
Magnus watches from the sun, waiting to repair what the others set amiss. You will give him that chance, Maraid. Everything depends on you.
I don't understand the lesson of this tapestry. What does it mean?
Mehrunes Dagon stands before Magnus as a weapon of hope. He possesses the power to shatter the mortal world so it can be remade. But a spark within the world is required to summon Dagon's cleansing fire from oblivion. You, my child, will be that spark.
No, Mother. I can't do that.
You dare deny your destiny, Maraid? The blood of emperors flows through your veins. This is your purpose. You will see it done.
Time is short. The mask will control your powers, protect you from them. And as long as you wear it, all will forget you, including yourself and your mother.
Thank you, Elegion. I can't do as she asks. I won't be responsible for the end of the world.
I will forget you too, Myrete. But I will leave you with my name, and I'll hold on to your father's amulet. If you ever need your memories, find me. The amulet is the key. This portal will take you to Fargrave, to a new life and a new world.
Can you really start to write for ease? Oh yeah, I would make only surprising stories. Horse to pets, the costumes and motive, and all of them will be accounted. Yes, exactly. Yep, exactly. If you want, you could also then later delete the characters, but you can also just have them there and, you know, use them for when you need them for events, to get more rewards or as a storage. Awesome looking tapestry, yes. Yeah, always when I talk about amulets, I always have in my head from the main quest, the Amulet of Kings. Yeah. If you need help with crafting, I can also craft you something, Onyx. I mean, you don't need so many. Would be as I usually make like two sets. One for like, I don't know, you know, like you make like a level 6 or 10, whatever you think. And then one I make usually with like, I don't know, 35 or 40. But you can also make more. But it doesn't matter so much. It's just more gold that you get the XP, bonus XP for training gear. So like, so that's the only reason why you need it. I mean, the champion points and stuff what you have, you can already immediately use, even if you have a noob cake.
My mind feels like shattered glass, reflecting images from a thousand shards. How can I sort through it all? Years of missing memories, flooding back in mere moments. What happened after I placed the amulet on the altar?
I saw some of your memories in this room.
Then you know. Sister Seldina is my mother, a consort of Emperor Morikar. Is that why I was hidden away, raised in secret? Gods, she raised me to destroy the world with an army of incarnates, to kill so many innocent people.
Elegiant helped you escape that phase.
It's all coming back. Elegion was ordered to make me a mask to protect me from my powers, but he secretly altered it to hide me from the Daegonists, from my mother. I have to confront her. If I can remember her now, then she can remember me too.
We can do this together.
No. I want her to see what I've become. The girl she tried to turn into a weapon is the same woman tearing down her wretched cult. The power of the mask is broken. I'm Mairead, but I'm also the Anchorite, and I'm through hiding from my past.
Okay. Anchorite, wait!
Sister Seldina must be nearby. I'll put an end to this myself.
No! Wait for us. Oh. Even if we have to rush, we have to read the books. Conan, did you set your controller for the dodge roll? Did you try it out? So far, I don't have any information about it so far, Harkonnen. I have no clue what is with the fourth member. No idea. Maybe we learned it later. I thought maybe we will learn it in the conclusion. But
the Phaedra are attacking! Nokfrost broke through the wards!
Ooh. Hello? Infernium.
For glory!
For glory! Yeah. We have to go this way.
Okanaz Nakfroz demands it.
Did she just pass by from all these enemies? He's fast, sneaky. Now LT
Stop
and
it. That's
A.
That's cruel and wasteful.
So you have to hold LT, and then click A. And then you use the left thumbstick for the direction. Also. Just click A, then it goes by default backwards. But if I, for example, put the thumbstick in front or to the side, it goes goes this direction. Sure. But you can also try a different combination. But I'm just used to it. I would say it feels really natural, but I'm used to it since I play for so long. But yeah, give it a try and see what works best for you for the wall dodge.
I remember. Maraid, together we can destroy Nern and set everything aright.
Yeah.
Set aright? I refuse to be your weapon, mother. I'm here to stop you.
Foolish girl. You do not know what you are, and I do not need your cooperation. You must submit.
Oh. Ah, so. You would just getting used as a weapon.
I should have waited for you. You have to stop her.
No. Nope. Nope. Here's Sister Selina.
You dare turn my daughter against me? You will be cleansed in the fire that remakes the world.
But it goes automatically, Onyx.
You cannot stop.
You don't have to
coming.
Do anything for the enlightenment, but you are automatically is it working? There's nothing
thanks,
what you have to do.
Mortal. You eliminated Sister Seldina and served up Morikar's heir on a silver platter.
Can you see that?
Her blood will fuel my perfected cataclysm.
You see?
With it, I shall conquer Fargrave for Mehrunes Dagon. And after
and
that,
you go with
your
the mouse
world
of it.
Shall fall.
Your character is enlightened and will earn
my
the next XP as accelerate rate.
Keep it safe.
Can you hear me, mortal? I'm opening a path to Fargrave. Hurry!
Shouldn't Sister Selina be called Mother Selina now? That's true, yes. Also, you don't have to do anything, Onyx. That's automatically applied always to your character. Nothing what you could have done wrong there. You did all fine. It's automatically there. So. And you can see when you go with the mouse over it, over your champion point bar, you can read it. Also, the game tells you also you're enlightened. You get the message when you log in. But also when you go here with the mouse over it, you have a, you can see what it's written there. So, all good. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
Ah, good. Now that you're here, tell me what happened in Deadlight. Vakanas Nokvraz and an entire cohort of Dromora attacked the portal to Deadlight. They overwhelmed and eventually shattered the ward. Rinkaius and I were forced to retreat. It seems I retrieved you just in time. Wait. Where is the anchorite?
We defeated Sister Selina, but Valkanas Nokvraz captured the anchorite.
Why would Valkanas Nokvraz take the anchorite? We saw that she had some power over the cataclysm, but what use of that would Nokvraz have? Unless... could he have succeeded in building his own cataclysm?
He said that he perfected catalyst. He said he had a perfected catalyst. But listen, The Anchorite's memories have been restored.
You unlocked her memories? Overcome the power of her mask? Interesting. And Nockfrost has a... what did you call it? A perfected cataclyst. Tell me, what did the Anchorite remember?
She's the daughter of Emperor Morikar and Sister Zeldina. Her name is Mayrit.
The daughter of a Longhouse Emperor and a powerful follower of Mehrunes Dagon. That's a recipe for, quite literally, disaster. But why did Nockfrost take the Anchorite?
Valkinas said he needed her blood to fuel his perfected catalyst.
We can't allow Nockfrost to harm the Anchorite or spill a drop of her blood. We will deal with that shortly. You ended the threat of Sister Zeldina and revealed things I did not know. I am satisfied with that, little mortal. Take this with my thanks. We can't leave the Anchorite in Valkinaz Nokfraz's hands. That would be a very bad idea. He can use her blood to create devastatingly powerful incarnates, abominations even I could not stand against. We must assault his fortress, Ardent Hope.
Do you have a plan for assaulting a Daedric fortress?
I always have a plan, mortal. We will require allies for this. Rinkaius and his blade bearers, and a way to get inside. The Waking Flame portal key will do, if we can attune it properly. And we need Aerox. He should be familiar with Ardent Hope.
How can we attune the portal key?
Portal keys, when properly attuned, can open paths where none existed before.
I've always to think about, you know, the keys from Harry Potter, where you touch it and then you get like dragged somewhere else.
If we have to assault the front gate, then we've already lost.
I will ask Madame Wim to attune the portal key to get us into Ardent Hope.
Go on. Use your charms to convince Madame Wim to aid us once more. In the meantime, I want to try another spell of identification on the twisted rod you recovered from an Nihilark summit. I believe I am close to determining its original purpose.
Would Norqua's fortress be protected against the portal key used by Waking Flame?
Why would They were allies mere moments ago. I doubt he expects trouble from a group of mortals he despises. It's possible the key already contains the coordinates to enter the fortress. I assume Sister Zeldina visited the place many times.
Can't you attune the portal key?
Perhaps, if time were not an issue. Besides, I can open my own portals to locations I am familiar with. I rarely use portal keys. We require an expert, and Madame Wim knows more about secret portals and byways than anyone in Fargrave, including me.
The Riven Catalyst was fueled by Tremora Essence. Why would the perfected catalyst need blood?
Mortal blood and Daedric Essence perform similar functions, and blood tied to rituals makes them more powerful. The cataclysts are basically rituals made manifest. Royal blood flows through the Anchorite's veins. That makes it valuable indeed.
You think the Twisted Rod is important?
You gave it to me to study. I studied it. It protects its secrets very well, but I have learned a few things while you were busy in Deadlight. It is an old relic that contains an enchantment as twisted as its form. It is disconcerting.
Do you know what the enchantment does?
Not exactly, not yet. But Aerox's essence is somehow tied to the relic. That could be why he was attracted to it. I will continue to examine it as time permits. Who knows? It may have a use we can exploit should the need
maybe
arise.
Maybe we can use the rod to bring Aerox back to his original form? What can you tell me about Ardent Hope?
It is one of the 777 impregnable citadels that house Mehrunes Dagon's legions. Nockfrost commands the garrison, protected by a cabal of Dremora blood adepts. That's why we need Aerox once we get inside.
Why do you think Aerox knows about Ardent Hope?
If we believe the Daedrat, he was once a mighty Daedra in service to Mehrunes Dagon, as well as Nokfraz's superior. If that is true, then he must know how to navigate the fortress. If we attempt a frontal attack, we'll never reach the Anchorite.
You really think we have a chance?
We have the same chance we always have, and we will find a way. What you told me raises questions about the Anchorite that I must have answers to. And you do not want Mehrunes Dagon's plans to succeed. So we shall deal with Nokfraz together.
Okay. Good. Not bad. So we have now done... Okay, I have four skill points left here. So they left four quests. Against all hope, the last ambition, ambition's end. Oh, the last ambition, see? Hope springs eternal. Love this add-on. Oh. See. So are we cleaning out the inventory? And then we are good to go. I have to still do tomorrow the bidding for our traders. Did not do that yet. But our inventory is not so polluted. Need to start with the Blackwood main quest. Oh, yeah. You should, Beaufray, you should. Slowly. And if you wait too long, then you will see, then there will be already the next chapter released.
More shall gather. More shall enter the fray.
Holy boo! Thank you so much for the raid! Good evening, how are you doing? Thank you so much, red pandas are the best. Yeah, thank you so much that you're raiding me. Thank you. Today you are faster. I'm also on the way to go to sleep. Today you are faster. Sneaky Holy boo! How was your stream? I hope it was good. Panda's looking like he's hatching an evil plan. Nein. We are Christmas Panda. No evil plan. No, 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 no.
Looking for something.
Okay. Achso, I didn't open my coffers. He was good. More of the same. Guitar and Rock Grove. You're really not never getting tired of the trial, huh? Profi. Panda in pyjamas? No pyjamas, no. I haven't done any dungeon for the tickets. In fact, this week I haven't done the weekly endeavors either. Oha, Orakan. But it's fine. I mean, you should be fine, oder? For the house and everything. Vacation is always good from time to time, Orakan. Yeah, that are wise words, indeed. The car looks like a pajama. Yeah. No, wait, I can show you something. I can show you a secret, wait. Eh? So. Now I saw some secret parts. Secret! Here, don't tell anyone. Okay? Don't tell anyone. I have the sleep pass already, when we'll be new here, it'll be a lot of time. Yeah. I've got a lot to do here. No! Okay, but now I go really to sleep. Seriously? So. Yes, we make this off. And then. We will go to sleep. Let me see what we are hosting now. And then we're returning tomorrow evening. Tomorrow evening we will play more Lego Harry Potter and we are in the third year. Nee, oder? Doch. Are we? Yeah, we're in the third year. Yeah, yeah. Ja, ja. So, tomorrow more Harry Potter Lego. And on Thursday, movie evening. Ach so, did not log out. So, we were hosting. So thank you so much for joining, everyone. Thank you very much for your love, for your support, for being here, hanging out. Thank you so much for buying the some of the merch. Don't forget, today you still get 20% off if you want to buy something. Use it. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here and hanging out and joining our questing time. Yeah, thank you. Thank you very, very much. Good night, Orakan. Good night, Olibo. Good night, Hexe. Good night, Logan. I hope your internet will work tomorrow perfectly. Good night, Tina. Good night, Elisira. Good night, Fuzzy Louie. Good night, Curse the Reaper. Good night, Alien. Good night, Beaufré. Good night, Whitecard. Good night, Siashu. Buenos noches, Huracan. Good night, Inaya and Daisy. Good night, Cyrun. Good night, Fnericle. Good night, Old Mama Dragon. Good night, Crazy Mad Hatter. Good night, Phoenix. Enjoy the class. Good night, Onyx. Bitte den Nico, wait, got time for Evil Dude. Enjoy, enjoy, Onyx. Good night, Olibo. Thank you for the wait. Good night, everyone. Sleep well and sweet dreams. See you tomorrow. Bye bye. Tschüss. Toodles. Good night, Dino. Good night, Steamy. Good night, everyone. Tschüss.